Start. The Prime Minister has just announced lockdown 4.0. Stop. Despite some resulting increase in economic activity, vast numbers of working people will remain without their regular incomes. Stop. He also announced a package of rupees 20 lakh crore, but this includes already allocated money of rupees 6 lakh crore and monetary policy directives to banks and non-banking financial companies. Stop. The announcements by the finance minister thus far involve no additional public spending, even though this is urgently required to revive the economy and prevent further contraction. Stop. Here we discuss what the government should do immediately in fiscal terms for reviving the economy and supporting livelihoods. Stop. Para. The immediate need is to provide free food and cash transfers to those rendered incomeless. Stop. Providing every household with rupees 7,000 per month for a period of 3 months and every individual with 10 kg of free food grains per month for a period of 6 months is likely to cost around 3% of our GDP, within bracket assuming 20% voluntary dropout, bracket close stop. This could be financed immediately through larger borrowing by the center from the Reserve Bank of India, stop. The required cash and food have to be handed over to state governments to make the actual transfers, along with outstanding goods and services tax compensation, stop. Para. This is easily doable for several reasons. Stop. First, food grains are plentiful, as the Food Corporation of India had 77 million tons and Robi procurement could add 40 million tons. Stop. Second, because of the lockdown restrictions, the multiplier rounds of such expenditure are heavily truncated at present and would not generate as much demand as in normal times. Stop. Third, cash transfers in many spheres will only enable current demand to continue, within bracket, such as payment of house rent to continue occupancy, bracket close, and not create any fresh demand. Stop. Fourth, when greater normalcy finally allows pent-up demand to surface, output could also expand because of resumed economic activity. Stop. Finally, putting money in the hands of the poor is the best stimulus to economic revival, as it creates effective demand and in local markets. Stop. Hence, an immediate program of food and cash transfers must command the highest priority. Stop. Para. But the post-lockdown world will be different for several reasons. Stop. First, millions of migrant workers have endured immense hardships to trudge back home and are unlikely to return to towns in the foreseeable future. Stop. Employment has to be provided to them where they are, for which the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, within bracket MGNREGS, must be expanded greatly and revamped with wage arrears paid immediately. Stop. The 100-day limit per household has to go, semicolon. Work has to be provided on demand without any limit to all adults, stop. And permissible work must include not just agricultural and construction work, but work in rural enterprises and in care activities too, stop. Para. The revamped MGNREGS could cover wage bills of rural enterprises started by panchayats, along with those of existing rural enterprises, until they can stand on their own feet. Stop. This can be an alternative strategy of development, recalling the successful experience of China's township and village enterprises, within bracket TVEs. Stop. Public banks could provide credit to such panchayat-owned enterprises and also assume a nurturing role vis-a-vis them. Stop. Para. The second change is the palpable unsustainability of the earlier globalization, which means that growth in India in the coming days will have to be sustained by the home market. Stop. Since the most important determinant of growth of the home market is agricultural growth, this must be urgently boosted. Stop. Para. The MGNREGS can be used for this, paying wages for land development and farm work for small and medium farmers, semicolon, apart from government support through remunerative procurement prices, subsidized institutional credit, other input subsidies and redistribution of unused land with plantations. Stop. Agricultural growth in turn can promote rural enterprises both by creating a demand for their products and by providing inputs for them to process, semicolon, and both these activities would generate substantial rural employment. Stop. Para. In urban areas, it is absolutely essential to revive the micro, small and medium enterprises within bracket MSMEs. Stop. Simultaneously, the vast numbers of workers who have stayed on in towns have to be provided with employment and income after our proposed cash transfers run out. Stop. The best way to overcome both problems would be to introduce an urban employment guarantee program to serve diverse groups of the urban unemployed, including the educated unemployed. Stop. Urban local bodies must take charge of this program and would need to be revamped for this purpose. Stop. Para. Within quote permissible work under this program should include for the present work in the MSMEs. Stop. This would ensure labor supply for the MSMEs and also cover their wage bills at the central government's expense until they are reacquire robustness. Stop. It should imaginatively also include care work, including of old, disabled and ailing persons, educational activities and ensuring public services in slums. Stop. Para. These measures are in direct contrast to those that seek to entice private investors by easing labor laws. Stop. The humanitarian crisis of the lockdown reveals the imperative for more, not less, labor production. Stop. Such measures, far from reviving investment or employment, would also further reduce domestic demand. Stop. Para. The pandemic has underscored the extreme importance of a public healthcare system and the folly of privatization of essential services. Stop. The post-pandemic period must see significant increases in public expenditure on education and health, especially primary and secondary health, including for the urban and rural poor. Stop. Stop. Yeah.